Somewhere in the outskirts of the interstellar realm, Voyager 1 is still exploring the unknown. After it had been pronounced dead by its operators, the space probe came back to life, and it continues to shock the entire world. Although the engineer team finally found the unbelievable cause of the data mystery, there is yet another secret that the space probe has hidden from us successfully. For nearly half a century, the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 spacecraft have been speeding through the vastness of space, teaching us amazing things about Earth and other planets, and scaring us on a couple of occasions. Since they took off from the Kennedy Space Center in 1977, they've covered more distance than any other spacecraft in history. The Voyager 2 was the first one to hit the skies, leaving the confines of the Earth's atmosphere on the 20th of August, 1977. Exactly 2 weeks later, the Voyager 1 set off to join its twin in space. NASA specifically chose to launch them during the periodic special alignment of planets, which allowed them to reach incredible velocity with numerous gravity assist maneuvers. This allowed the Voyager 1 spacecraft to race past its twin on the 15th of December, 1977. The probe arrived at the main asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter in January 1978, at a distance of 165 million miles away from Earth. This marked the beginning of the Jovian imaging mission. During this mission, Voyager 1 sent its first picture of Jupiter back to Earth. 1 year later, it focused exclusively on the gas giant for 100 hours, taking 3,750 pictures to showcase 10 rotations of the gas giant in a time lapse. The next stop was Jupiter's neighboring planet, Saturn. And just like it did when it flew past Jupiter, Voyager 1 revealed plenty of mysteries about Saturn too. It gave us more information about the F-ring, which was discovered 1 year earlier by the Pioneer 11 probe. The higher resolution cameras aboard the spacecraft also helped us to discover two new Saturn rings, Atlas and G-ring, as well as four additional moons around the planet. These discoveries signified the end of the Voyager mission within our solar system. But rather than retire the spacecraft, NASA decided to push the limits and send both the Voyager 1 and the Voyager 2 outside our solar system. This was something that had never been done before, but NASA had no doubt that the spacecraft were well equipped to survive whatever awaits them in the interstellar world. So they set Voyager 1 on its path at a speed of 38,000 miles per hour. According to official records, the Voyager interstellar mission began in January 1990, but it wasn't until August 2012 that Voyager 1 crossed the border of our solar system into interstellar space. The incredibly long journey to reaching that milestone was filled with many iconic moments. Perhaps the most special one happened on the 14th of February 1990, when Voyager 1 turned its camera towards Earth and took a picture of the planets in our solar system alongside the Sun. This picture is popularly called a solar system family portrait, although Mercury and Mars were absent from the photo. But thankfully, a lot of the celestial elements that Voyager 1 traveled past were nothing like them. In fact, the spacecraft shot around 67,000 pictures before leaving our solar system. But NASA decided to shut down its high-resolution cameras just as it was about to cross into the interstellar realm, basically to save power and memory space for the long journey ahead. As soon as it settled down into the intergalactic realm, Voyager 1 continued its lifelong goal of sending back valuable data from the world beyond. NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory reports that Voyager 1 is approximately 14.6 billion miles away from our Earth, still navigating the emptiness of space at 10 miles per second. But what was the problem with Voyager 1? Soon after crossing into the interstellar world, scientists began to receive weird signals from Voyager 1. NASA couldn't believe it because until then, the spacecraft had an impeccable reliability record. At first, they thought maybe the space probe had lost its way. But if that were the case, it would have automatically entered safe mode and notified scientists back on Earth. As none of the safety systems that were programmed to protect the spacecraft from threats have been triggered, crazy rumors took off, suggesting that the spacecraft had finally been intercepted by aliens. In this case, the extraterrestrials would have been learning the lifestyle of humans due to world-famous Golden Record and the letter by Jimmy Carter. As for the disc, it contains 115 analog photographs, digital content representing human culture and life on Earth, but also diagrams showing human anatomy, as well as our location in the universe. But it turned out that both the golden disc and the letter were still intact, just as they were in 1977, because the spacecraft wasn't captured at all. Consequently, NASA ran a check on the attitude control, and everything seemed to be working just fine. This system is vital for the health of the probe, and also for the mission. For one, it keeps the antenna pointed at Earth at all times, and also directs the orientation of the spaceship. While the system was receiving and executing commands just as it should, the scientific data it was returning back to Earth was deemed to be corrupt. However, the spacecraft is 45 years old, which is far beyond what the mission planners anticipated. Susan Dodd, the project manager for Voyager 1 and 2, said that a data mystery like that was sort of expected, but she also admitted that the engineering team behind the spacecraft faced a big challenge in trying to rectify the issue with Voyager 1. While NASA stated that until the nature of the issue is better understood, the team cannot anticipate whether this might affect how long the spacecraft can collect and transmit scientific data. But on further examination, the Voyager team found that the probe's attitude articulation and control system, aka AACS, was responsible for the erroneous data sent by the spacecraft. The AACS was discovered to be sending telemetry data through a faulty onboard computer that corrupted the files. Other than that, every other component was functioning as they should. Thankfully, engineers were able to fix the problem by sending incredibly difficult lines of code to the spacecraft, prompting the AACS to reroute its data transmission to another onboard computer. It was a quick and low-risk fix, except that the process of sending radio signals to Voyager 1 took 22 hours. But NASA didn't mind the stress. The most important thing was that the issues were fixed, and Voyager 1 was given a second chance to live and continue exploring the uncharted territories of the interstellar world. However, the situation is far from a happy end. While the problem has been solved, the team is uncertain why it occurred in the first place. The event suggests that there may be some other problems lurking inside the AACS that could damage the long-term health of the spacecraft. Scientists suspect that another faulty computer aboard Voyager 1 may have forced the Interstellar Explorer to send data through the initially damaged computer. If that's the case, then it wouldn't take long before Voyager 1 breaks down again. To avoid this, NASA is looking to carry out a full-scale memory readout of the attitude articulation and control system. The expectation is that it would lead us to the root of the original cause of the glitch, and that NASA can work to find solutions. Of course, this will go a long way to extend the lifespan of this legendary spacecraft, even as it continues to age gracefully in the interstellar world and walk the inevitable path to death. When it happens, we will remember this legendary space probe with its finest moments, just like we did when the operator team called for the final hour back in the day.